This poetry activity is called the Great Memory Animator, because the whole purpose of this activity is to kind of really animate or get you animating memories from your past and really thinking about them and then turning them into a poem, hopefully. Okay, so the first thing I want you to do for this activity, on a sheet of paper, it can be plain or lined, is to draw a bird's eye view of your first home. And your first home can be whatever you want it to be. It can be literally your first house you were born in, lived in for a while, or your current home because you can't remember the other one, or if you've always lived there, that's fine. So the first home, a bird's eye view, ideally of each floor in each room. So we need to get kind of a plan of each. So if you're doing a ground floor, you might draw, you know, if there's a front room and a back room, a kitchen, just sort of do a view of them, maybe in a rectangle or square shape. And then for each floor, do a separate bird's eye view plan. Okay? If there's only one floor, that's fine, just do that. Once you've done that drawing, that very simple drawing, and it can be as tidy or as messy as you want, there's no kind of regulations or expectations about that. Next, I want you to label some of the things in each of those rooms. So in total, if you can label at least five things, but I don't want you to just label them like wardrobe. I want you to use sensual information, something about the sight, the smell, the touch of them. So in my first home, for example, I can remember in our box room, we used to have a little box room. My grandfather used to live in there, used the room, and he used to buy me a bar of Toblerone every Friday, and it's this kind of dark wardrobe, but I always imagine the smell of Toblerone coming from that wardrobe, so I might label that Toblerone scented wardrobe. Sounds a bit weird, but it's obviously stirring up a memory for me, so I might use that memory later on. So try and label as many things as you can, so the weight of things, the touch of them, the smell of them, the way they look, and the more adjectives or descriptions of those things you can use, the better, I think. So loads of labeling, please. Okay. Once you've done the labelling, next stage, I want you to either imagine looking out the front door, or if there's a back door, out the back door. So if you're looking out the back door, you might look into a garden or a way out. But imagine looking either end. So looking out, what you can see on your left or on your right. So if you imagine the front, so as you come out your front door, you're looking down the road, other houses you can see. Maybe there's a really scary house when you're younger, it's really terrifying. Or there's some friends or relatives who lived in that, some of the houses. So you might label some of these houses with some description about them, who lived there, or, you know, or sensuous information again about them, the way you imagined it. And then imagine carrying on walking down the road. Imagine turning left or right at the end of the road. Are there shops nearby that you used to go to? Maybe some of the characters in the shops, or the first smell that hits you when you walk into the shop, or the kind of colour of the lights, or the signs that were there promoting, you know, the offers or whatever. Or maybe going the other way or same direction, there's the doctors nearby you might want to label, or there's a basketball court or a park nearby, or a school that you used to go to that's nearby. So label some of the places where you might have gone after school or during the daytime or weekends in the area. If you're labelling the back garden, try and describe the various things. Is there a shed there? Is there a hose? Try and label as many different things as you can, the various different types of plants. And all the time thinking about what you might have got up to in the garden and different things you did there. And hopefully the labelling will help animate the memories in the past or reactivate them. Okay, so once you've labelled everything now, you've got the various images all labelled, the writing activity shall now commence. It is one of two activities. You can either do one, which is to write about one of the memories that's been stirred up for you, either something that in the house, an object. So you could even just describe the object that's become very important to you because it reminds you of somebody in particular, or it reminds you of a memory or an incident. Or you might describe the incident. At this stage, all I want you to do is try and describe as much as you can, use sensuous imagery. So again, sight, smells, touch, taste. Even if it's a story that you're recounting, try and get all that kind of sensual information into it. because that's what really connects with the reader, because they can then really feel the thing. Okay, so that's the first activity. So either describing an object in the house that has lots of memories, or an actual incident that took place. And the second one, if there's nothing that really came vividly back to you, second activity is just a very simple, straightforward list poem. And list poems are part of the great tradition of English poetry, because they sort of have this hypnotic kind of feel to them. They conjure up a mood and really try and capture the essence of something. In this case, you'd be trying to capture the essence of your house. So the I Remember poem I want you to have. The title can be I Remember. And each line will start with I Remember. So in my case, it might be I Remember the Toblerone scented dark wardrobe. I Remember the gold-rimmed mirror. So, you know, just listing things beginning with I Remember. And some of these might be really boring cliches. Doesn't matter. Just write as much as you can using your chart. And then you might, in the editing process, think of other words to put in to make the whole list a bit more interesting. And good luck with your writing exercise. I hope you have a great memory animator moment.